Hi, we are at one of the most beautiful spots in Calcutta. This is the Lakes, Southern Avenue, also known as Robindra Sarobar. Now, this place was a complete mess even 10 years ago. But things have really changed with the Mamata Banerjee Trinamool Congress-led government. In fact, this is the Kolkata Corporation area. And today, in this series, we're going to take you to basic issues away from the conversation which the BJP is trying to make and distract issues. So today, we in fact, is a serious issue is how the opposition we've been saying is that the BJP is breaking down institutions. So seven institutions which have been destroyed, some completely destroyed, some in the process of being destroyed. What are these seven institutions which are being destroyed? So I appeal to young India, I appeal to not so young India to please vote the BJP out of power because they are destroying institutions. Let's talk about the first of those institutions, Parliament. The whole process of making laws have changed. Parliament has been disregarded. Only 20% of bills have been scrutinized. Just 20% of bills have been scrutinized by the 16th Lok Sabha. In the 14th and the 15th Lok Sabha, it wasn't 20%, it was 60%. By scrutinized, I mean these bills were sent to standing committees, because in Parliament, the bills get passed. But before that, there are parliamentary standing committees where these bills have to be scrutinized. Can you imagine? 60-65% earlier, now down to 20%. I mean, just bulldoze, no one studying the bills. Government is just bulldozing the bills, not studying clause by clause. Aadhaar bill, for example, also is another example about how this institution called Parliament has been bulldozed. The Aadhaar bill was taken off and plonked in there as a money bill. Bad times in the last 5 years. The second institution, I can have a full half an hour episode on this, CBI. In fact, in 2013, the present Prime Minister had said, the nation has lost its faith in the CBI. Well, Mr. Modi, the nation has lost its faith in the CBI, the ED, the income tax, because the way you are targeting your political opponents, that is like really, really terrible. Central government, there's so many cases, either in Andhra Pradesh, one day in Madhya Pradesh, in West Bengal, crossing the line, all for political vendetta. So all these important institutions have all become extended arms of the government. And of course, you all know what happened in the appointment of the CBI chief. So that's the second one. After Parliament, we come to CBI. Now let's come to the next one. The third institution which is being killed by this government. The third institution is, I almost forgot. No, I didn't. Federalism, all this talk from 2014, the government has been doing about federalism, but in fact, the president, while addressing Parliament, had said, they talked about the spirit of cooperative federalism. But what is happening in the cooperative federalism? I can give you a full bhashan on this, but let's take to one example. Let's take the railway budget of 2018. In fact, talking about the railway budget now has even been subsumed as part of the general budget. So there has been no railway budget. But if you look closely at the details, you will see Uttarakhand, BJP, Madhya Pradesh, that time was BJP, Gujarat, BJP. They got huge increases in the railway allocation in the budget. But what happens to states like Delhi, non-BJP, West Bengal, non-BJP, Kerala, non-BJP? They had railway outlays were slashed sometimes as much as 20-25%. The fourth one, the judiciary. You all remember that famous photograph of unprecedented four Supreme Court judges sitting outside on a lawn and addressing a media conference. And what was the subject? Interference in the independence of the judiciary. Cases have been assigned, breaking for a convention, and we all know, and I never like to discuss the judiciary because I'm from the legislative arm, but you all know what's happening. Let's move on to our next institution, number 5. Remember what happened? November the 8th, 2016. Another institution, ruined. And what is that institution? The Reserve Bank of India. No one knew about demonetization, except for Modi and his corporate cronies. Urjit Patel was the first governor since 1990 to resign from his post. Demonetization. Mamata Banerjee, you all know, within 1.5 hours of the policy being announced, said, withdraw this draconian decision. RBI was not even consulted. And then the government at one time tried to invoke Section 7 of the RBI Act and dip into the reserves of the RBI. So that's another institution destroyed or about to be destroyed by this BJP government. And that's why I appeal to our young India. I appeal to not so young India. You have to vote the BJP out, because institutions are things we cherish. Number 6, Lokpal. It took 5 years to appoint a Lokpal. That also, the Lokpal was appointed under pressure from the Supreme Court. It's not clear whether the other members of the Lokpal committee have been finalized or not finalized. And my 7th point today, from this beautiful setting in Kolkata, Southern Avenue, the lakes, is RTI. Modi Sarkar tried to dilute the provisions of the RTI through amendments which were later withdrawn. It aimed at destroying the autonomy of the Information Commission. For so long, an Information Commissioner also was not even appointed. How do you destroy? By allowing the central government to decide the tenure and the salaries of information commissioners. So very, very sadly, these are the big issues which India needs to focus for the election. So when you go out and vote, think of saving India's institutions, not destroying them. Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day.